people avoided walking on one side of the street where the trouble was, the street where the pain was, the side where the pain was, and they walked to the other side. We spend a lot of our lives walking on a certain side of the street, whether it has bad memories for us, the other one does, whatever it might be in your case. We spend time walking on that side of the street which doesn't give us pain, which might be very shady on a hot summer day. The side of the street that's comfortable where we know everyone's names. There was another street that I didn't like. I still cross here too, even though that family's long gone. They had a Doberman pincher. And I was on my bike, another biking incident. And I stopped and the dog was all around me and I was scared. And the postman saved me. And I still don't walk on that side of the street. We're really good at walking to the other side of the street where we feel really comfortable about things. Finding that place where we can avoid the pain and the suffering and the ugliness of life. Where we can have good memories. Christ challenges us to not cross the street when pain happens. To not cross the street when our neighbor needs us. To not cross the street into the comfort of what we know and who we know. Because we're told here, reminded here once again, that our neighbor isn't just the one we're comfortable walking with on the street, but it's everybody on the street of your life. Every single person. Even the lawyer got it. He knew what the law was. To love God, and above all, though, to love our neighbors as ourselves, as a reflection of God's love. In the first text we heard from Deuteronomy, we're reminded that that love isn't in heaven only. And it's not across the sea for someone to go and get. But it's in your head, your heart, your lips, and your own mouth. You have that ability to stay on the hard side of the street, to look around you at your neighbors, and to act in reflection of that. Even the ones you disagree with and don't get along with. We are called to show mercy. And we're told in the parable that if we do show that mercy, the best we know how, if we do follow the commandment and the law to love, that we will be repaid someday. Just like the person who walked on the street, that Samaritan, he stopped, he took the man to an inn, he gave the innkeeper money, he stayed around for a little while, he left and he said to the innkeeper, whatever you spend, you will be repaid. Christ walked in this world, and he gave, and he put us in an inn, in a house of God, in this church, to give thanks and praise, to find healing. And we were told by Christ on the day that he died, just as that Samaritan told the innkeeper, that we would be repaid in full when Christ comes again. That we have a place in heaven because of him. And that all we are asked to do is to look around and recognize that on all streets, in all towns, in all churches, there are gatherings of people of God, not strangers. We need only to look in our very midst, in the pew you're sitting in, to find the places where God asks you to walk and to be. We're called to start right where we are, not 10 years ahead or 10 years behind, but right now, right here. To continue to recognize that God's vision for the world is not out of reach. That it's in your very hearts and on your very lips and in your very ability to not let the fears of the unknown or the stranger make you forget that indeed we are all truly neighbors. We are called to reach out in Christian mercy and love, to do as God commands, to heal each other with of her today, I commit to you that knowledge, that power, and the ability to love another who is not like yourself, to walk on the street and see in your brothers and sisters God's grace and mercy, calling you to love and to be hospitable to all, to walk in solidarity with one another, to get beyond the surface of someone, and really know them and reach out and touch.